Hey everybody, it's that time again, another WordPress Wednesday. Thanks for joining me here on my YouTube channel. And if you love all things WordPress, be sure to search through our whole library. I've got over 200 videos here on our channel that are gonna help you improve your online marketing, specifically in the world of WordPress. All right, today I'm doing another video on Gravity Forms. If you watch my channel, you know I have an entire playlist dedicated to this incredible premium plugin. I call it a premium plugin because you have to pay for it, but the add-on that I've found today is in the budget of free. And again, if you follow my channel, you know I love the budget of free. So let's look at how to create a form where when somebody types in the entries, it can automatically turn it into a PDF file for them to download or for your team to get as well. It's super crazy cool. I'm gonna actually show you what plugin it is, as well as kind of show you how to set it all up. Again, on the budget of free, let's do this. So I'm talking, of course, about the premium plugin called Gravity Forms. You do have to purchase a license for this. And if you're kind to me, I would appreciate you using my affiliate link. That's in the description box below, but you don't have to. I just want to show you how cool this is. We highly recommend the business license at $99 a year because you get a lot more add-ons, plus you can put it on a couple different websites. And I say it's per year because you definitely want to have the support and updates every single year. So you certainly want to look at understanding that in your budget. But you're going to be blown away by how cool this is. Let's get into it. The add-on that I want to talk to you about is called Gravity PDF. And what I want you to also do, if this video is a little bit older that you're looking at this, I want you to be sure it's been tested with your current version. We're running 4.8, so it's okay for our current version. It's been updated recently. Again, I want you just to confirm that it's been updated recently and be sure that the ratings are still really great as they are right now. Just extraordinary, extraordinary options, totally for free. So I'm gonna show you, I've already created a form using Gravity Forms on my website. I want you to see kind of what these fields look like. And I'm gonna show you now how to get in here and basically add in this add-on for Gravity Forms and set it all up. So you're gonna go into your plugins and say add new. And of course, we're talking about the WordPress.org version of WordPress. You cannot do this on, as of today, on WordPress.com. So you're gonna do a search for Gravity PDF is what you're looking for. And this plugin right here is the one that I've activated and is the one you want. So you're gonna click install now and then activate it. Once you've already done that, which I've already done, once you go over to your form section now, this is what's cool about it is every single form, if you wanted to, could have its own PDF. It doesn't automatically apply to every single one of your forms because you might not want your contact form to have the ability to be turned into a PDF, but we've got this here. And if you go under settings, now you have an option for PDF. So we actually want to create the template specifically for this form that we've created, testing PDF Gravity Forms. So we're going to go in here now to the PDF section of this particular form, and we're going to click Add New. Now, all you got to do is just kind of fill in the blank here. So this is for admin purposes only. So we're testing the meetup form. Let's just throw that little label in there. These are templates of how you want the PDF to ultimately look, and you can play around with the different default options that they have for you here. Or if you need something even more advanced and really dynamic looking, one of the ways that this particular theme or plugin developer rather has monetized this is by creating premium templates. Check this out. So if you wanted to, you can click on this little link right here. It says go over to our theme shop. You can also build your own, by the way, or hire them to build a custom one. But here's their template shop that has all sorts of really cool existing templates that'll give you really amazing style for these PDF files, invoicing, letters, really, really cool options and for a very, very minimal expense. Like these are $19. That's a pretty phenomenal buy. So, but you don't have to, because check out what we're about to do for a budget of free. We're gonna go ahead and set up the rest of this these options here. So if you want a notification, you can add in a notification. It gives you the ability to give it a custom file name. So for your own filing purposes or for the individual, for if it's a receipt. So we're gonna say meetup, and I actually wanna do the person's first name, and then I'm gonna do their last name. And this is of course based on the fields that are inside of the form, right? Because I've got a first name option here and a last name. So whatever they put in there dynamically will help us name this file. Oh, that's so cool. We're going to go over to appearance now. They give you some different paper size options, which is crazy amazing. They also allow it to be portrait or landscape. We're going to leave all of these to default for now, just to, for the purpose of this video, to show you kind of what it will look like. I'm going to go over to the template area. Again, unlimited options here. Do you want to show the form title on it? Do you want to show, if you have a multiple page form that has like different page breaks, you can put the different page names at the top of each individual page. Just phenomenal. If you have a section break, really cool options here. I mean, this developer definitely knows all the facets of Gravity Forms. One of the other cool things they give you here totally for free is the ability to throw in your own custom header or footer. And you can even use a different header on the first page if you wanted to maybe have some sort of a welcome message. Very cool. So let's go ahead and add in, at least to show you kind of what it could look like. We're going to throw in our logo for now. I'm going to insert that into the post and just put my logo in the middle there for the sake of now. Up at the very top, again, you have some advanced options. This is interesting, allowing for security purposes for some PDFs. So I would just pay attention to what these options could be, and we're going to say add PDF. So basically what we've done is we've created a template now on how that PDF is going to look. It has the branding on it now, and it's got the file name on it now. So now we've basically created the function. Now we need to give the ability for somebody to actually download it or get to that PDF. So let's show you how to do that. That's the last step of this. It's really kind of cool. This plugin now gives us a short code. So we're gonna grab this download short code option. I copied that onto my clipboard right now. And I'm gonna go over to the confirmation section of this particular form. And right now I've already kind of given it a default message as we click edit here. It says, thank you, please download the PDF as your receipt. And all I'm gonna do is paste in now that short code here that allows for the download option to happen. And I'm gonna click save confirmation. That simple, y'all. That easy. And if I went too fast, I know I'm a Southern girl, I talk pretty quickly for one, but I tell you what, pause, rewind me, go through this step by step. It's gonna work perfectly for you. So let me show you the end result of what all this is gonna look like. I'm gonna click refresh on the front side of this website. We're gonna fill out the form really quickly just so you can see what it will ultimately look like here. Our favorite food is pizza. We're gonna donate $100, why not? And these are just silly fields, so you can kind of see the different options for that Gravity Forms has the ability of doing for you. Kind of cool. We're going to give it an age of 8 here. I'm going to add another just so you can kind of, again, see what the options are here. And let's just say 4. And let's add one more in here, again, just to kind of fill up the page so you can see what that's going to look like. And we'll do this, and then we're going to give it an email address in here, and I'll throw in a phone number in here. And then, of course, you can just testing all of the fields. So I want you to see now, as I click submit, now we're going to move over to the confirmation. So it says, thank you, please download the PDF as your receipt. And now you see the link here for download PDF. I'm going to click to download. It's going to open right away in a PDF viewer for me. And look at this. Here's all of our fields laid out beautifully. There's our total. There's our logo on there. And I'm going to move this down in the screen so you can see. Look at the title up here. Meetup Corey Ashton 2. And that 2 is there because I already had done some testing previous to this. How cool is that, you guys? It is a PDF. It's available now for the individual to download. And I'll show you one last really cool feature of this. Inside the confirmations, or the entries area now, of this particular form, you know how you can always see the entries, but now we actually have an area that's not just viewable to see all the different entries here, but now we can say view PDF. So your admin team can come in here and view that PDF or download that PDF as well. It's saved in your library. Incredible. This is all for the budget of free. Isn't this outstanding? Now dream big with what your different options are that could be for this use as people fill out different forms, an application, or maybe it's some sort of a an option to join an event, and this is going to be the receipt. There's just endless opportunities. If you love this video, be sure to comment in the thread below, or give me a Twitter shout out. I'd love to hear from you, and I will see y'all next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, everyone.